In one of our previous videos, we talked about how the Analyst used different forms of manipulation to trap Neo, and he did the same to Trinity. Although deep down, she also knew something was off, the entire system worked to keep her under control. In this video, we will be talking about all the means of manipulation that the Matrix used to imprison Trinity. Welcome to Matrix Explained.
The desert of the real.
The first method used by the Analyst was the same he used on Neo, changing her digital self-image. We can see the character's different DSIs in a few scenes. In the coffee shop, by pausing on Trinity's reflection on the table and flipping the screen, we can see what Trinity's DSI looked like in the simulation. Just like Neo, the people in the simulation saw Trinity differently. For them, she was a Caucasian woman with long blonde hair. Neo, however, could see the real her. Something interesting about Trinity and Neo's DSIs is that Trinity's alternate look is played by Sarah McTeague, the wife of the film's producer and co-director, James McTeague, who was one of Neo's fake DSIs, the bald man that Bugs saw about to jump off the building. A real-life couple chosen to play the alternate versions of an on-screen couple. This is just one of many meta Easter eggs in the movie. But back on topic, the Analyst used Trinity's love for motorcycles to control her. One of the things that stood out the most about Trinity's character in the previous trilogy was her preference for motorcycles, especially the Ducati. She used them for transportation, obviously, but she also used them as weapons. As we've mentioned in a previous video, the Analyst takes a person's achievements, ideals, and dreams, and uses them against the person to trap and control them. The use of motorcycles was part of Trinity's iconic look and personality, and so the Analyst turned it into her hobby. Trinity herself told Neo, "I love motorcycles. My friend Kush and I actually build them. You have your Analyst, I have my bikes." Although she is speaking about pastimes or hobbies, she is unintentionally laying out exactly what the Analyst was using to control them. Therapy for Neo, and motorcycles for Trinity. Trinity's friend Kush is a handler, just like Neo's friend, Jude. They are in charge of keeping a close eye on them, to stop them from walking too far off into reality. But the strongest and cruelest control method the Analyst used against Trinity was her family. We don't know if any member of Trinity's family was human, but we are sure that at least her husband was a bot. The family was handcrafted by the Analyst to keep Trinity busy. There were several moments when Trinity mentioned that she doubted reality, especially when she discovered the video game, The Matrix. She saw a physical resemblance between her and the game's character, Trinity. She pointed it out to her husband, who was a bot, and he started laughing. She told Neo that she started laughing too, but she hated herself for doing so. Trinity's children were also constantly interrupting her meetings with Neo. The system has managed to manipulate Trinity by assigning her the role of a housewife, a complete contrast to the rebellious Trinity from the previous movies. Trinity tells Neo, "I remember wanting a family, but was that because that's what women are supposed to want? How do you know if you want something yourself, or if your upbringing programmed you to want it?" This connects to what Morpheus once said to Neo. Neo felt that something was wrong in his day-to-day life, when he paid his taxes, when he went to church. Is because the Matrix is a system that controls all aspects of society, but it is also a symbolism of reality. Never do people question their roles. Study, work, pay mortgages, have children, all are goals that we naturally establish as normal, and we rarely stop to think if that's what we want, or if it's that the system has already programmed us to want them. On the other hand, what Trinity mentioned has a double meaning. Saying that having a family was maybe programmed is a reference to the bots, which are programmed to supervise. Now let's talk about the name Tiffany and the Analyst's inside joke behind it. When Trinity finally wakes up, it was partially because of her deep hatred for the name Tiffany. Then she beats up the Analyst for giving her that name. He mentions that it was an inside joke. The name Tiffany comes from the old word epiphany, which means revelation, a vision, or spiritual clarity. It also has other meanings, such as God incarnate, or manifestation of God. So what's the joke? Trinity comes from the Christian dogma that says that God is composed of three different entities, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The names Trinity and Tiffany are similar in meaning. They speak of the nature of God, His incarnation, or manifestation. It's a wordplay that nearly ends up saying the same thing. Yet ironically, Trinity hates the name Tiffany. The last manipulation tactic the analyst used was that he allowed Neo and Trinity to get close in the simulations to then forcefully separate them to cause them suffering. Their suffering increases the power output that they generate for the machines. This is why Neo's quote-unquote friend, Jude, introduced them to Trinity, even though he is a bot. The analyst wanted them to get together to then separate them, perpetuating this cruel cycle of pain. Neo and Trinity knew deep down that they should be together, but something won't let them. In the final scenes of the movie, Trinity says to Neo, "After you left, I went home and I played it. I kept thinking, why does this story feel like a memory? There's a part of me that feels like I've been waiting my whole life for you. And that part is like, what the hell took you so long?" This piece of dialogue made us understand a couple of things. Possibly the analyst used the video game The Matrix to torture Trinity. Also, just like with Neo when he subconsciously created the new Morpheus in hopes that he would find him, Trinity subconsciously was waiting for Neo to find her. This is also an analogy of people who are trapped in their life, with a family they possibly didn't want, with a job that they hate, and always wondering if this is the life they wanted, waiting and hoping for the moment to escape, but eventually accepting that it may be too late, like Trinity did. At the end of the movie, Trinity punishes the analyst for using children. So were they bots or real humans controlled by the analyst? We'll talk about that in another video. The manipulation used on Trinity was more practical, so to speak. Not nearly as complicated as Neo's, but it was more difficult to break. But do you agree? What do you think about the emotional manipulation used to control Trinity?
The place where you live is not the place you once dreamed of. Are you sick of your hot and filthy Zion apartment? Then we have the solution for you. Bad credit or criminal history? We can wipe your slate clean and give you a fresh start. We at Megacity Realty can find you the most luxurious real estate, where you can spend hours playing your favorite virtual reality video game, eating the most delicious meals, and having an endless supply of blue medications. What are the blue pills for? No need to worry, because you will be bathing in the most phenomenal bathtub, with the best view of the city, and only minutes away from the best cafeteria in the city. Why wait? Contact one of our agents and be reconnected to the home of your dreams. Megacity Realty. Offer valid while the truce lasts.
For Matrix Explained, please leave a like and subscribe. And thank you for visiting the Desert of the Real.